Another issue I've been asked to talk about is drug treatment. Drug treatment dystonia has been around for decades, since the last century, and perhaps disappointingly, a lot of the drugs haven't changed much since the last century. And drug treatment is still an area which can be beneficial, but often in many patients is not very effective. The type of drugs that are used are those which usually have an effect on chemical transmission, so neurotransmission within the brain, and they have an effect on how certain brain chemical messengers work. Probably the most old-fashioned and oldest drug are a class of drugs called anticholinergics. So acetylcholine is the chemical messenger in the brain, and one of the things we know about it, it's very important deep within the basal ganglia, which are a group of nuclei within the brain, which are very important for controlling how we move our body. And we know that if you have problems with the basal ganglia, it can lead to dystonia. And so it's been shown, there have been trials in the last century where they used anticholinergic drugs, and the ones that used to be called benzhexol, it's now better known as trihexyphenidyl, can have a beneficial effect for childhood onset generalized dystonia of any type. It's sometimes used in adults, but it's less effective. The other chemical messenger class, which is sometimes has drugs used in dystonia, is a chemical messenger called GABA. Now, one of the other things we've learned about dystonia is when we're moving, one of the most important things your brain is doing is if you're performing a task, the brain is making sure any muscles that interfere with that task are inhibited, they're not excited, so they relax. And what happens in dystonia is when you move or you perform an action, too many muscles get involved, the muscles fight each other, and that's what's produced the dystonic spasm. So GABA is a very important inhibition chemical messenger in the brain at all levels. It's in the brain itself and also within the spinal cord. So these drugs are trying to increase the amount of GABAergic stimulation, increase the amount of inhibition to try and improve dystonia. And the two really main players in this, they're the benzodiazepines, of which diazepam or Valium is one, and clonazepam is another one, which has been used for many, many years in dystonia. It can help relax the muscles. And the other one is a drug called baclofen. And they work in different ways, but they work on the same chemical messenger pathways. They can be helpful. The risk with benzodiazepines is people can become hooked on them, and they become less effective with time. With baclofen, it's more with side effects, so they can be sedating. So with all these drugs, the way we use them is that certainly for more generalized dystonia, we'd get involved with them. Start very low, slowly build up, and to try and find the lowest dose that's producing a reasonable effect. People do need to be monitored, so it's usually by movement disorders. Neurologists would follow them up because you want to make sure, are they working? Are they producing side effects, or should they actually be stopped? And they can be quite useful, but not in all cases. For the more common focal dystonias, they're less useful, although quite a lot of people who use botulinum toxin also will often find a very low dose of one or the other, such as an anticholinergic, can have a beneficial effect. And I know certainly some people feel that as the effect of the botulinum toxin injections wears off, the fact they're on a low dose of one of these drugs can stop the dropping off being quite so bad before they have their next cycle. So they can have a use when used in combination. And then there's a whole class of other drugs which are used usually just in case reports, sometimes anti-epileptic drugs, sometimes drugs blocking dopamine transmission, but really there's no trial evidence and really it's trial and error. But in many cases, particularly for the adult onset focal dystonias, which are the most common forms of isolated dystonia, drugs aren't always that effective.